There are currently over 14,000 animals on the International Union for Conservation of Nature's Red List of Species that are facing extinction. So should we let nature take its course or step in to save them? I mean, species come and go over time. Look at the dinosaurs. Actually, you can't, because they went extinct. Studies suggest that species are going extinct far faster now than before, and we're to blame. We keep cutting down their forests, paving over their lands they have nowhere to go, not to mention we introduce new predators and diseases. So maybe we should preserve them out of guilt? Or maybe we should keep the incredible variety of nature around? It's a puzzle. The Endangered Species Act of 1973 states that threatened species are of aesthetic, ecological, educational, historical, recreational, and scientific value to the nation and its people. But take away the things we're doing to kill off species, and all the things nature is doing to weed them out, and it's still really hard to preserve some species. Because animals need to mate to make more animals, and helping them accomplish that is harder than you'd think. For one thing, we've got to get animals in the mood, and it's not always that easy. We don't always know the social factors they need to become aroused. For example, in a managed space, like a zoo, the zookeeper might clean up the enclosure, inadvertently removing something that's a super turn-on, like a pheromone signal. We can look for physiological issues too, like if they're not mating because they're sick. But even if they're healthy and we're not messing with their environment, maybe they still don't mate, and often we have no idea why. So is it worth the effort? That's not for me to say. I'm an animal lover, so I say yes, save all the animals. But there's another thing to consider, money. Captive breeding programs have been in existence for about half a century, and some have been really successful. But regardless of outcome, the one sure result of a breeding program is a lot of time and energy spent trying to keep species off that endangered list. The California Condor Reintroduction Program was one of the most expensive efforts ever, costing a total of more than $35 million since 1987. And giant pandas can cost upwards of $2 million a year to host in a zoo. But there's an upshot. Having a rare species like pandas in a zoo for breeding will attract visitors, particularly if and when there's a baby to come see. That's revenue that can go a long way to fixing their habitat and figuring out how to get those pandas to mate. On the other hand, some would argue that the money spent on zoo enclosures and breeding programs would be better spent preserving natural habitats so the animals aren't displaced in the first place. There might be a loss of revenue from visitors, but nature preserves are still really fun to visit, even if you aren't as likely to see an exotic and interesting furry friend. So there's a lot to consider when we talk about conserving species, but I still vote for saving all the sweet little and big animals. If you love science, be sure to subscribe for more Seeker. Zookeepers sometimes have to go to extreme lengths to get animals to mate in captivity. These pandas are watching porn. Yep, that's real science. Watch it on Wild Sex right up here. And it gets weirder. Scientists have actually done in vitro fertilization with pandas. Thanks for watching.